Having a Mac is an investment that you will get many years of use out of. Eventually, you will find yourself wanting to upgrade to a newer model. When this happens, you have the option of keeping your older Mac or trading it in to OWC to help offset the cost of your new machine. Should you decide on trading it in, you'll want to return your Mac to a factory setting, meaning it should be ready to be set up for a new user the moment they power up the device. There are a few steps you will need to take to get your Mac to a factory setting. Hi, I'm Michelle for OWC Rocket Yard. Here are the steps you will want to take when preparing to trade in your Mac. Assuming you're upgrading to a new Mac, the first step you will want to do is make a current backup of your important files that you have stored on your current Mac. Using Time Machine to create regular backups of your Mac's internal drive is a good practice in protecting your data. To use the Time Machine feature, purchase an external drive, like OWC's Mercury Elite Pro, and connect it to your Mac. Use Disk Utility to format the external drive to an Apple-compatible format. Disk Utility will suggest the format depending on the type of drive. Select Use Disk as Time Machine Disk Backup once your drive has been formatted. Alternatively, you can copy files from your internal drive from the folder locations of documents, movies, music, pictures, and any other internal drive locations you store your data to. Sign out of any services you have on your Mac, such as iTunes, iCloud, iMessage, and any other subscription-based services. For Intel-based Macs, you will want to reset the NVRAM to return certain settings and security features to factory default. Power down and then restart your Mac. Hold down the following keys when you restart: Option, Command, P, and R. Hold down those keys for 20 seconds, then let them go. An optional step is to unpair any of your Bluetooth devices that are connected to your Mac. Go to the Apple menu and select System Preferences, then select the Bluetooth icon. Select the Bluetooth device and click the X on the right side of them to unpair. If you're using a Bluetooth keyboard and mouse, you will then need to connect them by USB in order to continue using them for this next step. Erasing your hard drive. Make sure you have no external drives or accessories hooked up to your Mac, other than your keyboard and mouse. Power down your Mac, then restart, and hold down Command and R. Release the keys after the Apple logo appears on the screen. After a moment, your Mac will boot in macOS recovery. Select Disk Utility from the list of options shown. In Disk Utility, select Macintosh HD on the left sidebar. You will want to select the Erase button in the toolbar. Disk Utility will then prompt you for the name and format of the HD. Leave these at their default. If Erase Volume Group is not shown, then just select Erase. Once the erase is complete, you will want to delete any additional volume that isn't named: Macintosh HD, Macintosh HD data or disk images. Reinstall macOS. Make sure you have access to an internet connection for this step, as the recovery utility may need to download the OS from the internet. After you have erased the internal drive, you will want to install macOS from the recovery utility you are currently in. Select the Reinstall macOS from the option menu and select Continue. If you're asked for a location on where to install macOS, make sure you choose Macintosh HD. During macOS installation, you will notice that your Mac will restart multiple times and show either nothing or a progress bar for several minutes at a time. This is normal. Do not close your lid or put your Mac to sleep. Once installation is complete, your Mac may restart and go into Setup Assistant. Press Command Q to quit the assistant without completing setup. Select Shut Down. Your Mac is now factory reset. The new owner will now be able to enter their own information and complete setup. Now that your computer is ready for sale, check out OWC's trade-in program, where you can get cash for your trade-in Mac. Find out more on the trade-in page at macsales.com, which you can also find at the link in the description below. When you're ready to say goodbye to your Mac, follow these steps, including erasing your data and factory resetting your device. This will keep your information secure and help you get the most resale value for your Mac. I'm Michelle for OWC Rocket Yard. Thank you for watching.